What up, book lovers?
It is G-Swizz here, and I'm here today to talk about the 9 books that I need to read in 2019. Okay, so I did like a 9 books I have to read before 2019 video, and I think I got to majority of them, but I don't think I got through all of them. Maybe one appears on this list, but then the rest I want to keep fresh, and I also want to make sure they get to them by the end of 2019. I will potentially be doing a reaction to this video maybe at the end of the year, that is, if I do read these books, and I'll probably wrap them up there. But I really do want to challenge myself to get to these books, because some of these books are the most intimidating books to my TBR, and some of them I've just needed to get to for a while. So yeah, I guess without further ado, I'm gonna get started with the 9 books I plan to read in 2019. Okay, so pretty much, let's state the obvious. I need to get to Archenemies by Marissa Meyer. I wanted to get to this by the end of 2018. That didn't happen, and I'm happy that that kind of didn't happen in a way, because I was going through burnout, and I didn't want that to affect my reading experience. Can't say that I'm fully refreshed at the moment, but if I am more refreshed, oh, there was a bookmark in there, that's great. If there comes a time this month that I'm more refreshed, I definitely wanted to get to this one. This is the next Bibliosquad book pick of the month. I don't know specifically which month this is for. This was meant to be our December pick, but then our live show is being pushed to like February or something like that because we've needed a bit of a break. I've especially needed a break. Everybody else deserves a break. I'm just hoping to get to this one this month specifically, but also this year, because this series concludes this year. Whoa! The next book I have to mention that I really do want to get to by the end of the year is a book that I want to get to before a specific point in the year, just like Archenemies. And I want to read this before Avengers 4 comes out, and that, my friends, is Thanos, Titan Consumed by Barry Liga. If you guys don't know, this book counts as MCU canon according to the writers in the MCU. They wanted to include Thanos' backstory in Avengers Infinity War so bad, but they couldn't fit it in because it would have made the movie a bit too long. So Avengers Infinity War started at a very random time within the MCU timeline for Thanos. Even though Avengers Infinity War was somewhat of a full movie, it didn't include everything we needed to know. I feel like it definitely included enough for us to pick up on, but it didn't include the full picture. And when I say the full picture, I mean Thanos's backstory. Like, we barely got to know past Thanos and why he is the way he is. We do get to know why he believes in what he believes, but we never really get to see it for ourselves. And so this is what this novel is all about. And so I definitely want to know why this Titan is consumed by his quest. Another book that I definitely want to get to, I mean, like, comic book series, I will say, that I need to get to, that I've been accumulating for the past couple of years, and it finally needs to happen after so many people keep on telling me that I would love it. I need to make sure that the hype doesn't get to me. I don't want it to intimidate me anymore. I just want to buckle down and read it. And that, my friends, is Saga by Brian K. Vaughan and Fiona Staples. I currently own 8 out of the 9 volumes that are currently out. And so I guess I have to say, if it's taking up space on my shelf and if I'm not reading it, then what's the point of it being there? I need to get to this. I know that I will somewhat enjoy it. I mean, because it's a sci-fi space opera adventure. I know that it's 18 plus, and I don't think that I would have been able to read it at a very younger age, but now I think I can definitely handle the violence in here. So I definitely do want to get to the series. I hear nothing but great things about it. I don't have anything else to say about it, really. Okay, this one is hecka intimidating, but it is the name of the book pick of the month for January or February. I'm not too sure. I don't know which month they're taking a break either. It's good that some of our book clubs are taking breaks because we need it. We need a breather every once in a while. I've told myself that I wanted to read this book more closer to like when they confirm that we are going to get the final book in the series, but turns out we are going to read it anyway. May as well jump on it with the book club. And it's funny because our book club's name is the name of the book, and it's named after this book, or like it was inspired by this book technically. And that, my friends, is The Name of the Wind by Patrick Rothfuss. I don't know if I'm gonna ever really get to The Wise Man's Fear this year, but I definitely do need to get to The Name of the Wind. This book is like 700 pages. I'm hoping I will be engaged while reading it. I'm actually very scared and very intimidated of this book, but so many people keep on telling me that it's amazing. And guys, I'm not gonna lie, I really do want to get into high fantasy. There are so many booktubers I love and I absolutely adore that read high fantasy and they're able to buckle down into it. I really want to get into it. I don't know why. I feel like I'm less engaged in high fantasy as opposed to other fantasies like urban fantasy or maybe even sci-fi. I personally prefer sci-fi and I also personally prefer urban fantasy, but I really do want to get into high fantasy. I have some high fantasy on my TBR. are, and this is one of the high fantasies that I really do need to get to, and it's just the favorite book of many people. So I'm hoping that this will be one of my favorites. Fingers crossed. Speaking of sci-fi, we have a sci-fi on this TBR that I've needed to read since 2015. I've wanted to read since 2015. It is 2019 now. It's been almost 4 years. The shame is real, but this better be the year that I read it. And that, my friends, is The Martian by Andy Weir. Watched the movie around 4 years ago. I purposely have not watched the movie again because I've tried to forget what happens in the movie. I mean, it's actually pretty memorable, so it's really difficult to forget what happens in the movie. But the reason why is because I want to read this book with the freshness of it all. And I've told this story on my channel many times, but I got taken to see the movie for my birthday. I think it was my 20th birthday, and I'm usually the one that reads the book before I see the movie, but I was surprised, so I got taken to see the movie before reading the book. Whereas my sister's boyfriend at the time, now fiance, he read the book before watching the movie, and he never reads books. He actually studies films, so it's really funny. He read the book before watching the movie, and that's usually my position. So we technically swapped positions there, and he was definitely more skeptical about the movie, whereas I loved the movie, and it was just so funny because that's usually my position. I'm usually in his position. He's probably usually in mine. I'm not too sure. I can't really assume. But it was just so funny to hear his thoughts, him breaking down the differences between the book and the movie. Anyway, that's beside the point. I really do want to get to Martian this year, and I definitely want to listen to the audiobook because apparently the audiobook is a masterpiece. Everybody is still raving about this book. Like, years later, that's when you know that it's a pretty good sci-fi. Now we're moving on to a dystopian. A dystopian I've needed to read for years. I'm pretty sure I put this on my TBR in 2017, and I put it on my TBR in 2018. Now I'm putting it on my TBR in 2019. It needs to happen, or else I literally don't know what to do with myself. I just keep on procrastinating. It's not fun. Anyway, I'm going on a tangent. I just need to move on and talk about The Handmaid's Tale by Margaret Atwood. This is a classic that is actually getting a sequel this year, so that better be another motivation for me to actually read it. It's funny because the motivation originally was the fact that there was gonna be a Hulu series. Actually, no. As soon as I finished 1984, I knew I wanted to read this. You know what? The reasons just keep on accumulating. They keep on coming. So many more reasons to read The Handmaid's Tale, and I just don't do it. It's frustrating. But I need to get to it. I'm gonna get to it. I better get to it. If not, you have every right to judge me. The third last book I have to mention on this list is a YA novel that everybody was raving about last year. It was definitely one of the most hyped up books of 2018. And this is definitely something that I am not usually interested in reading, but I'm very curious, especially because apparently the audiobook is told like a podcast. I'm not even into podcasts yet. I mean, everyone keeps on asking me,
G-Swizz, what podcasts do you listen to?
I don't listen to podcasts. My spare time, I listen to audiobooks or I watch YouTube. I need to get into podcasts, let's be real. But I feel like reading / listening to this book will make me experience two new things, or two things that I rarely experience. One of them being things in podcast format, as well as experiencing a YA thriller. I barely read thrillers. I think that this is a perfect time to actually buckle down and read Sadie by Courtney Summers. Pretty sure I purchased this book at a pre-Christmas sale at Dimmick's, and it was the final copy on the shelf, and I put it on my to be bought list. I'm so happy I put it on my to be bought list, and I picked up the last one before anybody else could grab it. It's so popular. It is very well praised, very well known here in the BookTube community, and I just want to experience something different. And that's what I've been challenging myself to do. Like, I don't do TBR challenges anymore, or I don't really participate in too many readathons, but I try my best to challenge myself to really expand my reading taste when I'm in the mood to do so. Because let's be real, I'm a mood reader. I read what I want, pretty much. There are times where I just want to expand my taste. And this will pretty much be an expansion if I choose to read it this year. I better read it this year. I've put it on the books I need to read in 2019. And the final two books I need to read in 2019, I'm putting together because they're by the same author. Both of them are intimidating, but I need to read them this year because one is a book club pick and one is a book that I've needed to read for years, and I need to finally buckle down and read it. So the book that I've needed to read for years and finally read it is The Bone Season by Samantha Shannon. You guys are gonna know where I'm going with this. The final book on this list is Priory of the Orange Tree by Samantha Shannon. The Bone Season, I've just needed to read for years. I've wanted to read it for years. And I feel like now I'm potentially more ready than ever to read it. I mean, I think this would have probably been a DNF if I would have read it years back, because apparently the series is very confusing and the world building is so rich and so big. That's all I really hear about this book. That's the reason why I've been putting it off, and I feel like maybe potentially this is the year that I will get into the series. Whereas with Priory Diary of the Orange Tree. This is going to be one of the name of the book picks of the month this year. It's definitely on the slate. I need to read it. Honestly, I feel like the best way to read this very thick tome is to read it with the book club. I don't know if I'll have motivation to do so otherwise. So that's gonna be it for this video today, book lovers. If you want to purchase any of the books that I need to read in 2019 today, book lovers, all the Book Depository purchase links will be down in the description, so you can check them out, you can purchase them, and you can help me out by doing so. And I also have social medias. I'm at G-Swizzelbooks on Twitter and Instagram, and I'm also at Goodreads. That's www.goodreads.com/gswizzle. I love you, book lovers, and I will see you later. Peace!